What's up, family? It's your boy, Big Tommy Burns here with Beasts of the Bay Strength here in Lafayette, California. Man, it's been a week since our man, John, maintenance and facility worker here on the premises of the gym passed away, last Thursday in his vehicle. And man, it's been a rough ride of a week. I tell you that it's been nonstop. You know, I told you guys the story last week that while this was happening and unfolding, of course, the kids and the babies were with me, and so you know, life don't stop. You know, especially when you're an adult man and you're a parent, right? You gotta keep adulting and keep parenting. And so was able to, you know, just work with the kids and talk and process with them after that event unfolded. And then right after that, you know, life continued to go on, to move on. Like, the operation of the day didn't stop because of a very unfortunate situation. You know, came to the gym that evening, which I do every day, well, Monday through Friday here in the evening time, and then Saturday here for a couple hours during the day, to serve, you know, clients and members that are coming into the gym. That was the same day, you know, it didn't stop. And then Friday, the next day, it's the same thing. Get up, be with the babies, make sure they're cared for and everything. And then went out to celebrate the weekend with my wife, our anniversary of our first date. And then, man, Sunday, it really hit because things started to slow down. I didn't plan anything. And I had planned on it emotionally hitting around that time and really just taking the time for myself. And, you know, started to get heavy for, it was heavy for a few days. I was in limbo emotionally for days and just operating and moving, because it just it was sad. But at the same time, for me, you know, things have gone well, right? Life, family, business, momentum, it's been everything that I prayed for and worked for. And then all of a sudden, you know, this. And normally that's something that I would try to handle myself and kind of like sweep it under my emotional rug, so to speak, and just try to handle myself as I have with, you know, many situations in my life. And unfortunately for me, it triggers. I've been sharing with my wife for days, you know, it's been triggering PTSD in me because of the amount of death that I've experienced in my life. You know, it triggers me being in the same situation at 14 years old and us finding my mother, who was only 29 years old and had a stroke in her sleep, and finding her and then holding her as she took her last breaths. It started sparking in me, you know, being in the same house in the next room as my grandmother unfortunately was murdered from somebody shooting in the house, shot in the head with an AK-47. I was 8 years old at that time. Triggered for me, you know, being a kid, 6 or 7 years old, and watching your cousin get ran over by a drunk driver and not surviving that. It triggered for me getting the call at 1:05 in the morning while I'm on my way to a leadership convention on a bus that my little brother had been shot and it wasn't looking good. And then praying with my uncle, and then a few minutes later, him calling and crying and saying he didn't make it. He was 23 years old. You know, uncles passing away from cancer the same year that I was, the same year, same month that I graduated college, being a first generation graduate of college. My oldest uncle passed away from cancer. Didn't suspect it at all. He was just, you know, hurting, stomach was hurting really bad. He would normally be like me emotionally, sweeping under the rug, I can handle the pain. But when he was complaining about it, family members said that there's something wrong. He went to the hospital, never came out. And I graduated college from Howard University in 2008, the next month, while he was in hospice, and he passed away. So, same uncle that gave me the call, my Uncle Beaver, about my little brother, you know, a year later after my little brother passed away, he passed away, diabetes. And so there's so much death. You know, 2020 was a hard year for many people dealing with death. And fortunately, you know, hit us hard, not in the sense of me personally knowing anybody in my family that passed away from COVID, but my father decided he didn't want to be with us anymore after going through some experiences that he went through. And he, you know, that year he decided not to be with us anymore. So throughout my life, I'm 39 years old, I'll be 40 in October. I've been to easily 25 plus funerals of family members and close friends. And at some point I just had to stop going and made that decision in myself because it triggered all of this stuff again. So here I am in another phase of life where things started to fall into place, and we start building this energy and this place. And finally, after 8 years of working and seeing the vision and working toward the vision, you know, get a gym facility, right? And it's a place where I want to fill with positivity and optimism and empowerment and all good things. And literally a month after being in ownership of it, this situation comes up. And so for me, it's not all bad, meaning that, you know, it hasn't caused me to spiral and just say, man, everything is horrible. Like, it's been really good. And so I have a dual reality that I'm dealing with, where I still have joy and gratitude for everything that's happened and happening in my life, for the blessings that I have with my family and loved ones and friends. But then the sadness of, you know, this situation, sad that John had to leave. You know, leave this realm. Sad that John had to leave this realm in, you know, this arena, in this space, on the premises of the gym. So I have a dual reality where, you know, there's joy, but there's extreme sadness, and it had been extreme sadness for a while, and I'm now just kind of like resurfacing emotionally, where I'm okay. And I know that it's because I've made a decision that I'm not going to allow this to take me out, right? And what I mean by that is not necessarily like take me out as in kill me, but take me out as in caused me to come to a screeching halt because I didn't pay attention to all of the things that I should have paid attention to and addressed them. That's been me in the past, dealing with all of that stuff that I talked about. And I've never been to therapy, never really. I've had one coaching experience And it wasn't really for that stuff, but it's been for life stuff, right? Because normally I'm the person that people come to be a sounding board, to be a voice of reason, to be a coach. And so for the first time in my life, I started seeking out therapy. And I'm very happy to, you know, share with you all that I will be going to therapy for the situation that happened with John last week, but everything else. And I'm very excited. And I'm going because it's just too much on the line for me to neglect myself in that way and then try to sweep it under the rug, and knowing that, you know, I'm a parent with little babies and a busy schedule and a business and things are gonna happen, and I'll keep sweeping stuff under the rug until it's unmanageable, right? Right now it's very manageable for me. And this is the time that I know I need to handle it. While I'm feeling good, before it becomes unmanageable, before that spiraling experience starts. You know, last year I was at, just over a year ago, man, I was at that place. And I've been in that place too many times in my life where I just swept everything under the rug. I didn't address things as I needed to. I neglected myself. And so we're not doing that no more, right? This ain't that. And I'm very proud of the maturity that has shown up in me. And it's interesting because a good friend of mine made a post yesterday, and I'm like, wow, it's incredible when you have such connections with people. And he said that he was getting ready to go to therapy and starting therapy after, I think, 22 years of stuff. And we have pretty similar paths with like deaths of parents and things like that at young age. And I'm like, man, it's amazing. And we hadn't talked about that. We had talked the night before that post, in fact, but I never shared with him that I was going to therapy and starting therapy, and he didn't share with me that he was. And so I was like, man, it's amazing. It's definitely definitely a year of new beginnings and new happenings and abundance. And you know, I want to share with you that, you know, you may be facing a dual reality. You know, there's always two sides to every experience. Nothing is 100% all bad and nothing is 100% all good. In fact, we really don't know what is really bad or good until we've long passed that experience. Because if we look back in our life, a lot of things that we probably consider bad in the past, we look back on that and it made us make a decision to get us to a place of progress and growth in our life when we look back on it now. And had we not gone through that, what we consider bad experience back then, we wouldn't be where we are today. And we'd probably be, you know, comfortably sitting way back there when we wanted to be way up here, right? And so my man Myron Golden says it like this. He says, you don't really know what's bad while looking in the windshield of life. You only know what's bad or good when you look in the rearview mirror. That means you have to get way past the experience and see it in the background to say, oh, that was good for me. Oh, that was horrible for me. Because a lot of things that we considered probably was good in the moment, and we thought that they were good, they probably turned out to be some of the baddest things that we could have experienced, right? And a lot of things that we consider bad in the moment, and we thought it was gonna destroy us, we look back on it and it made us stronger. It made us figure things out. It made us pull out this strength inside of us that we did not know that we had. And so I'm very excited about this chapter of life. And man, I'm gonna just keep sharing the journey. you know, keep sharing a journey with y'all. And my gift is that I've always been a transparent person. You know, I've been a person of strength and a person of growth and a person of joy and positivity, but I've always shared the opposite as well, right? I've never put on like things were always great, but I always have done the best I can to be the best person that I could be, to learn from mistakes and to grow from those things. And to, and I use you all as a community of accountability and grow for me, you know? And then of course, I hope that what I share, when I share, that it encourages you as well for what you are going through, because I know that you're going through something, right? And it don't have to be horrible, but I know that life's for us all. So thank you guys for being sounding boards for me, and I appreciate you. We're gonna keep sharing this journey. This Saturday, we have our first Strongman Saturday here at Beast of the Bay Strength. And so if you wanna come out, be a part of that. It's free for all of our gym members, free for youth, high school age, youth and younger, sponsored by the Driven Athlete Foundation, our nonprofit 501c3 organization. And it's only a $20 drop-in for any guests that wanna come out and train with us, man. So. It's going to be fun. We're going to have log press, car deadlift, and some other things going on, working on the outside, and then some stations on the inside as well, and just having a good time from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. here at the gym, Beast of the Bay Strength Gym in Lafayette, California. I look forward to seeing you at the gym or whenever our roads cross again. Thank you again, friends. Peace. Have a great night.